Another option that I have for you is you can also use AI to help you to work on your discussion. I'm not saying that you use it to write it, but you can use it to generate ideas that will help you to work on your discussion, right? So it's for only idea generation. Well, you can use ChatGPT to do that. What you could do is that you can ask ChatGPT to help you come up with ideas about each of the session based on the themes that you have. And I have an example here. This one, I created it from ChatGPT. And as we can see here, these are the prompts that I use. So first, I indicated that I'm going to provide themes that I've come up with, and I wanted to provide some ideas for me for all the sections that I provided, like interpretation, connection to the literature, implication, and recommendation. And what I also did was that I provided the system an example. This one is so important. In order for you to get a very good outcome, you can provide ChatGPT an example. So the second prompt is given an example. So I provided a theme, I provided my interpretation, a connection to the literature, implication, and recommendation. And then I told the system to follow this example and do the rest of the themes for me. Give me ideas about interpretation, the connection to the literature, implication, and recommendation. I also asked the system to provide me a list of references based on the citations that the system gave. This one, you have to be very careful because ChatGPT can make up references. So you always have to cross-check and make sure that they are correct. And lastly, I asked the system to create a table. By so doing, I was able to get this one from ChatGPT. So I supplied the themes and the system generated this information. As I said, it's just an idea to help you to start the writing. It's not a perfect outcome, but it gives you some ideas, right? What you should think about when you are writing your implication, recommendation, and interpretation. I can quickly show you how I use ChatGPT to do this so that you can follow similar steps. So let's go to ChatGPT and let me show you how to do that. I use GPT-4, the paid version. That's what I use to create the table. But let's try and first use the free version, GPT 3.5, and see what we're going to get. And I will also use the GPT-4 later. In discussion session, you can get access to this PowerPoint when you look at that place, right? I put this, the first prompt here. So I'm just, telling the system that I'm planning to write a discussion. I want some ideas. And I also give information about the themes. So the themes about the causes of burnout. I instructed a system that it should help me to create ideas or points for each of the components in terms of interpretation, connection to the literature, implication, and also recommendations. So this is the prompt that I provided. So let's see what the system will do. Okay, so there's a response and it's showing that it is happy to help me. So let me copy the second prompt and see what will happen. Okay, so it's telling me that we can proceed. I copy and paste this one. I'm telling the system to use this theme. So I've provided the themes and then see what will happen. So you see how it has provided me the interpretation connecting to the literature and implications for each of the themes that I've provided, right? So as I said, it's not going to be perfect, right? But it gives you some ideas. And then I tell the system to give me the list of references. So also you always have to cross-check and make sure that these references are accurate because the system can confidently provide the wrong answers. So you always have to check. Okay, so now we have the reference. So the next one, I want the system to create a table based on the output. So let's see whether the system can do that. It can create a table for us. It looks like the system didn't understand. it taught that you are asking it to create a table based on the reference, but I'm asking to create a table based on this information. So what I can do is that you can go here, edit, and you can put that question here because you are telling the system to create a table based on what it has generated in terms of the discussion ideas. You can click submit here. Now you see it has created a table for us. This is nice. We can see that you can use the free version to do that. If you have the paid version, you can follow the same instructions and see what you're going to get. This is what I have for you. If you want to use ChatGPT to just help you to get started with writing your discussion. I think we may get a similar results when we do the same thing for the paid version. So let's try the paid version, which is GPT-4. So I'm going to copy the first prompt. Let's see. Okay, so let's copy and paste the second prompt. So as you can see here, that is generating the components of the discussion information for you. This one is very interesting because I have not given ChatGPT the themes I want it to work on, but it looks like it generated its own theme. So what you're going to tell the system here is that you want it to use this theme instead. So I say use the following themes instead. And I provided a theme for my study. And then I submit and see what you're going to get. Okay, so you have to be very careful here that when you're using the paid option, it will generate its own themes for you. But you have to prompt the system that you want it to use the themes for your study. So you see how now it's generating information based on the theme for my study. As you can see here, the next step was to ask a list of references based on the information that it has provided. But I want to put this one to prompt 5, the last prompt, so that it will not confuse the system, because I want the system to create a table for me. So I will make it part of the prompt 4. So the prompt 4 should be, can you put the output in a table format? So let's ask that question. So now it's creating a table based on the themes that you provided to the system. Then I'll ask my last question, or I'll give my last prompt, which is, can you provide a list of references based on what you cited? So I go back here. And as I always say, always check. Make sure that the references are correct, right? Okay, perfect. So this is what you're going to get. From my experience, the paid version gives more specific and detailed information and also accurate information compared to the free version. So if you have both, you can compare and see the difference. But I think if you don't have the paid version, you can use the free version to get some ideas and then start writing it.